They are some of the ocean's smallest inhabitants. And on coral reefs, microorganisms are copious creatures.
Microbes are very prolific on the surface of corals, both in healthy and diseased corals.
But in a world that's invisible to the naked eye, drastic changes are taking place.
Whether it's Australia or the Bahamas or the Florida Keys, all the scientists see this microbial power shift.
With healthy corals,
when temperatures increase, pathogenic bacteria go up and the beneficial bacteria go down.
Just like when we get stressed out, we're more likely to get a cold. When you stress out these corals, they could potentially be more susceptible to bleaching or getting a disease.
Throughout Florida, scientists painstakingly work to identify key players within this microbial community.
It's estimated that you can only culture 1% or less of the bacteria that are out there, but yet corals have thousands of different kinds of bacteria associated with them.
While some of the bacteria found on corals are important to their health, others can lead to disease outbreak.
This bacterium was killing the coral. We could hypothesize, based on what we knew about the bacterium, that it might be coming from humans. Usually we hear about pathogens from wildlife to humans. Examples are HIV, swine flu, avian flu. But we haven't had the reverse, and so this is a new disease mechanism that we're not familiar with, especially in the marine environment.
With experimental sites in the lab and in the sea, what will microbes reveal about coral health? How do human activities impact the microbial balance on the reef?